Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading solar media. And today we have Mr. Abhinav Mahajan with us from IB Solar. A very warm welcome to EQ, sir.
Thank you for inviting me here.
Sir, can you just let us know about IB Solar, like from when it came into the solar industry and what are the plans in 2021 and 2022?
Basically, IB Solar is derived from Integrated Batteries India Private Limited. Our company is incepted in 1992. So we have been into batteries distribution, importation and distribution. We were Panasonic channel partners across India. In 2013, with the vision to make solar as a mainstream of energy, we diversified into solar industry. And in 2015, we set up state-of-the-art manufacturing facility in Noida, Sector 63. Our annual production capacity presently is 90 megawatt. So we have been supplying solar panels to several states, and our major market share is in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, West, few parts of Rajasthan, Jharkhand. We have been the leading supplier, because Jharkhand last year also we supplied close to 4.5 megawatts, and this year also we have got close to 7 megawatt of solar panels orders in hand with us. So this has been our journey so far. In last 6 years, IB Solar has made a good niche in the market and is recognized as one of the leading solar panels manufacturers brand.
And any new technology you have come up?
I was about to come on that. Last year we tied up with Sofar Solar for promotion of on-grid inverters across India. And Sofar Solar, we are presently importing and supplying close to 9 to 10 megawatts of inverters in several parts of India. Sofar Solar has its good market share in states like Punjab, Haryana, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Kerala. So all these states we are supplying good amount of inverters. Now we have opened new counters in Madhya Pradesh. Now when you talked about new technologies with IB Solar, yes, market is evolving. Market is changing very rapidly. Presently we were supplying panels in poly cells till 335 watts. In mono PERC we launched 420 watts. Now market is dramatically changing. Is moving towards higher rating of modules because of high efficiency of cells available. So next year we have procured the land in Greater Noida, Ecotech, and next year we'll be starting the work for setting up new manufacturing line, which will be offering 600 megawatt from its facility, and it will be state of the art facility with leading machineries, and we'll be introducing our 600 megawatt. Now with changing times, as we have seen that market has moved from lead acid batteries to lithium ion. So in next 2 months, we'll be introducing our lithium batteries also. And that plant is about to begin in next 2 months' time. So probably by December, we'll be introducing IB Solar in-house made lithium batteries, which will be targeting solar market, EV market, as well as energy storage market.
So as you talk about the distribution, that's in Pan India itself. So what are the plans for the export, like to go for the international market as well? Are there any plans further coming up?
I would like to proudly like to let you know that we have already exported. 2019 was a game-changing year for us when I started exhibiting in countries like South Africa, Nigeria, Ethiopia, Kenya, and I attended with some company in Dubai also. And these all countries I exhibited. Now with this I got very good exposure, and 2019 end we got our first major breakthrough order for around 450 kilowatt of panels plus batteries plus inverters. We supplied to Zambia, and those systems were to be installed in Corona health centers, COVID health centers they were there. Unfortunately, due to lockdown, the supplies got disrupted, because in March we were to supply. We got special permission from Zambian embassy and Export Promotion Council of India to start the factory operations, because those supplies were very critical. So we run our factory during the lockdown also, last year I'm talking about, and we ensured supplies. By June end, we made our first export. And since then, we got another order for Nigeria from Nigeria for around 250 kilowatts, and these were all scattered sites, 5 to 10 kilowatts each. So this was given us back to back by an Indian company only based in Nigeria. So this, then Dubai, we got a third order. Fourth order, we got about 4 containers from Lebanon. These were all batteries. Export, thankfully, to this pandemic and all, people have started some negative effect has come to their minds against Chinese products. So people are bending towards more over to Indian products. And as it is, a lot of thrust has been given by this current government on Make in India. And exports also, we have been given targets of around $400 billion. So that is also being considered in mind. And a lot of efforts are being taken to make sure that Indian companies, not only about solar industry, but making India as an export hub for electronics, for textile, for software, for pharma sector, for healthcare, and of course solar is a integral part of it. So yes, we are very satisfied with what export market we are being able to capture. Even today, like, we have got around 7 to 8 container orders pending with us from countries like Lebanon and Syria. So these are all mixed orders, like batteries, panels. So people in those countries, they prefer mixed orders. They prefer to have import one container in which everything is integrated. So it's not like they want to spend exclusively on inverters, exclusively on panels, or exclusively on batteries, because they have some constraint on the purchasing power also. So they prefer to import containers in which there is a mixed. So IB Solar, as a manufacturer of panels, as manufacturer of batteries, they come to them as a very handy solution, because everything, and we match their target prices also, because since we are manufacturing, so we are able to match their target pricing. So export is also becoming a very good, I would say, share the of our business turnover in last one and a half years. And my personal focus is more on the export side now. Now I have I'm giving more and more focus on exports, because exports has got its own charm. And
that's great. Okay, if we talk about, like, there are various international brands who have been set up in India, and they are joining up with the Indian manufacturers. So what do you think, like, how it will be, like, it will be challenging, or it can be like opportunity? We should look at, like, opportunity for us, for the Indian manufacturer who are into the solar industry space.
Did you ask, like, the foreign companies who are willing to cooperate?
There are, yeah, they are.
It's a huge opportunity, because any company with their technical power, technical knowledge, technical know-how, If they would like to collaborate or join hands with Indian manufacturers who have got the setup, who have got the right liaising with the government, right market knowledge, right market awareness and market coverage, and they have got the right setup means they have got the they have got the land available, they have got the mainly space available, and they can invest on the plant and machinery also. So I would say that even we are welcoming those foreign companies who wish to set up their operations in India. So it has to be Make in India for selling in India. I am totally against importing and all. So if some companies have to capture Indian market, they should come as a making Indian partners, as a making Indian companies as right partners for them for selling in Indian market. And right partnership can be collaborating or joining hands with them for setting a manufacturing locally.
And as you know, like, government has set few targets for the solar industry specifically. So do you think, like, is it achievable, or it will be challenging for the market?
It is already achievable, and we have achieved more than what targets were set. So we set up around 175 gigawatt of targets, and we have already achieved 100 gigawatt, and around 60 to 70 gigawatt is in pipeline. So I think we are well on targets, and the credit goes to all the current government. They are the actions they have been proactively taking. So I think the kudos to them for achieving the targets. It's already achieved.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.